Hello everyone. Today, you will learn about the influence of renewable energy sources in the application of control. And you will be briefly introduced to the control mechanisms used in microgrids. In traditional power systems, the power balance is achieved by controlling the generation plants by means of the governor. The power system of the future will have a high participation of renewable sources, such as offshore wind parks and solar parks, which are not controllable. This poses new challenges to the system. The primary, secondary, and tertiary control should then account not only for the changes in the demand, but also for changes in the generation, especially coming from the uncontrollable sources. In order to cope with these challenges, more complex control and optimization algorithms are required, as well as forecasting methods, not only for the demand, but also for the generation. Some of the forecasts that are likely to be considered in the future are demand forecasting, wind and photovoltaic production forecasting, heat demand forecasting, and electricity price. In large power systems with high participation of offshore wind generation and large solar parks, forecasting methods and storage will play an important role. In traditional power systems, primary control is performed locally at the generation unit. On the other hand, secondary and tertiary control are applied in a centralized way. However, this is likely to change in the future. Let's have a look at the difference between centralized and decentralized control. A centralized control is more suitable if there are common goals or a common operation environment. The number of nodes is generally limited, and the number of message exchanges is also limited. In this case, suboptimal solutions lead to profit losses. A decentralized control is more suitable if there are multiple actors with different goals. In this case, a suboptimal solution is probably acceptable, given the high costs related to the communication network and complexity of the system. Decentralized control has the potential to operate in systems containing a large amount of distributed generation and actors. A microgrid can operate in grid-connected or off-grid mode. The control can be centralized or decentralized, depending on the characteristics of the system. Let's assume centralized operation when analyzing the following case. When the microgrid operates in autonomous or off-grid mode, the voltage and frequency should be determined by the power converters in the system. In the case of a centralized supervisory control, one converter, known as master converter or grid-forming converter, regulates the voltage and defines the current references for other converters, known as slaves. The master converter operates as a voltage source inverter and the slaves as current source inverters. A supervisory control is responsible for defining the power dispatch and the generation units and applying flexibility to the system, using storage units, for example. Another possibility to provide flexibility to the system is to apply demand-side management techniques, both off-grid and on-grid. When connected to the grid, demand-side management techniques can be used to provide ancillary services to the main grid. By applying demand-side bidding, consumers are allowed to provide bids to shift their demand or allow its curtailment. In the shift option, consumers can place two different bids, one for the supply of their high-priority loads and one for their low-priority loads. In the curtailment option, consumers can offer to turn off low-priority loads at fixed prices. These kinds of bids would fall under the economic optimization of the system. Today, you were briefly introduced to the concepts of centralized and decentralized control, as well as to demand-side bidding, based on shift and curtailment of loads. Would you like to see an example in which these concepts are applied?